Hello friends, you are familiar with few expansion and factorization formulae, right? You know how to write a plus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square, as well as the factorization of a square minus b square. You know how to interpret them geometrically as well. Now let us try to interpret a plus b plus c the whole square geometrically. It is quite simple and similar to a plus b the whole square. As we wish to expand a plus b plus c the whole square, it suggests that it is area of a square with side a plus b plus c, right? So let us start with a square whose sides are of length a plus b plus c. See, this length is a, the another one is b, and the third is c, correct? And now area of the complete figure is equal to area of each of these small portions. Now this one is a square with side length a, so we'll have area a square. The second one is a rectangle with length equal to a and breadth equal to b, so its area is equal to ab. Similarly, this rectangle has length a and breadth c, so is of area a into c. Once again, here the length is b, so this rectangle is of area a into b, as this side is of length a. This is a rectangle with sides b, hence is a square and has area b square. And the last one is a rectangle with side lengths b and c, so has area b into c. Now this one is a rectangle with sides a and c, so has area ac. This one has lengths b and c, so the area is bc. And the last one is a square with sides c, so area is c square, right? So now we have these 9 pieces, and areas of all of these will add up to the area of the complete figure, that is a plus b plus c the whole square. So we can write a plus b plus c the whole square is equal to, now we will write the additions of the areas of each of these small pieces. So equal to a square plus a b plus a c plus a b plus b square plus b c plus a c plus b c plus c square, right? Now you can see that the term a b appears twice. Similarly, the term AC also appears twice, and the same is true for the term BC. So if we collect the like terms together, we can write it as A square plus AB plus AB will be twice AB plus AC plus AC, which is twice AC, plus, now this AB is taken here, plus B square plus BC plus BC, which is twice BC, plus these two are considered and only the C square is left. So we obtained expansion formula for A plus B plus C the whole square. the formula is very much similar with the a plus b the whole square, isn't it? Now let us try to expand 2x plus 7 into 3x plus 4. Remember that here x represents some number, it is a variable, right? Now what is the meaning of 2x plus 7 into 3x plus 4? As it is a multiplication, it is area of a rectangle whose sides are of length 2x plus 7 and 3x plus 4. So on a sheet of paper, let us draw a rectangle with one side equal to 2x plus 7, this length is 2x and the remaining is 7, and the another one has length 3x plus 4. So area of the rectangle will be 2x plus 7 into 3x plus 4, correct, which is nothing but the left hand side of the equation. Now let us try to expand it by looking at the figure. As it suggests, this length is 2x and the another side has length 3x. The area of this rectangle is 2x into 3x, which is equal to 6x square. For the adjoining rectangle, one side is 7 and another one has length 3x. So its area is 7 into 3x, which is equal to 21x, correct? For this rectangle, the side vertical length, this length is 4 and the horizontal side has length 2x. So the area is 4 into 2x, that is 8x. Now for the last one, this rectangle has sides 4 and 7, so its area is 7 into 4, which is equal to 28, correct. Now if we add areas of all of these pieces, we will get area of the complete figure, which is nothing but 2x plus 7, that is length of this side, into 3x plus 4, which is this length. So area of the complete figure, which is this, is equal to first area, which is 6x square, plus area of the second piece, which is 21x, plus area of the next piece, which is equal to 8x, plus area of the last piece, which is equal to 28. Now there are two terms involving x. This has x square, so we cannot add the term directly with these two. So we can simplify this further as 6x square plus 21x plus 8x will give 29x, and 28 as it is. So we obtained 2x plus 7 into 3x plus 4 is equal to 6x square plus 29x plus 28. Understood? Now let us try to expand a plus b the whole cube. Here we don't have multiplication of 2 but multiplication of 3 terms. We are multiplying a plus b 3 times to get a plus b cube, right? So geometrically it does not represent the area, but it will represent the volume. But we can do some manipulation, some adjustment, and show it on a piece of paper. How? We have to do some adjustment, which is we can write the a plus b cube as a plus b into a plus b the whole square, correct. And as now it is a multiplication of two terms, one is a plus b and another one is a plus b the whole square, it will represent area of a rectangle whose sides are of length a plus b and a plus b the whole square. Okay, now how to do this? Now it's easy. Now take a rectangle whose one side is of length a plus b, correct? Another side should have length a plus b the whole square. Now how to achieve a plus b the whole square if we have the lengths a and b? We already know a formula for a plus b the whole square. Let us use it here. What is it? It is a plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Do you remember? Now, if we use this formula to have the another side, see it here. This side has length a square plus 2ab plus b square. So, the total length of this side is addition of the 3, which is a square plus 2ab plus b square, which is nothing but a plus b the whole square. Hence, area of the complete figure rectangle is nothing but a plus b into a plus b the whole square. Hence, it will be a plus b cube. Okay. Now, there are various regions formed in the piece of rectangle. Let us try to get the individual areas. Okay. This has length a and another side has length a square. So, the area of this piece is a cube. For the second piece, the length is b and length of this side is, as we know, a square. Area is a square b. It is multiplication of the two. For this one, the side length is 2ab and another side is a. So, area is multiplication of these two, which is 2ab into a, which is 2a square b. For this one, the sides are 2ab and b. So, the area is 2a into b square. Fine. Now, for the last two, this one has sides b square and a. So, the area is a into b square. And finally, this is a rectangle with sides b and b square. So, it gives area equal to b into b square, which is b cube. Okay. Now, if we add all of these six areas, we will get area of the rectangle as shown. Now, if we add areas of all these six rectangles, we will get area of the complete rectangle, which is nothing but a plus b the whole cube, as we have seen earlier. So, we can write now a plus b the whole cube, that is area of the complete rectangle, is equal to a cube plus a square b plus 2a square b plus 2ab square plus ab square plus the last one b cube. Right? Now, here there are two terms with a square b and there are two terms with ab square. So, combine them to get a cube plus 3a square b plus, once again, 2 plus 1, 3 ab square and finally b cube. So, we obtained a formula for expansion of a plus b the whole cube, and it is a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. Okay. Now, try to get the expansion formula for a minus b the whole cube. You will need to do something similar as a plus b the whole cube.